c'est le clou du moment, vraiment c'est le big événement.
I'm sure there are better races in many respects, but Le Mans really has something which is just not around in any other motorsporting event. It's not just the race, it's the whole attitude, the whole atmosphere that surrounds this week of speed.
Le Mans has been called many things, La Ronde Infernale, the Infernal Roundabout for one, but it still remains for many the greatest of all sports car races. In 1969, there's a strong entry, including Porsche, who are making an all-out effort to add a further victory to the sports car championship they've already won. Tremendous interest centers around the aerofoils fitted to the 908s and the new 4.5-litre 917s, which are said to contravene the FIA regulations made hurriedly after the Monaco Grand Prix. Rico Steinemann, Porsche team manager who drove to second place last year, threatens to take the cars back home if they aren't allowed to use the fins. He says,
well, we would have done it because we think you ought to be consequent, you ought to be straightforward-minded. It's just no good to let yourself to be pushed around.
Michael Parks of Ferrari has scrutineering bothers too.
We've had a slight problem with visibility through our rear window because we haven't got, in fact, a rear window, as you probably saw, but a series of alligator slats, which vertically you can't see through and horizontally you can. This has not been completely accepted and we're waiting an FIA ruling on it.
Chris Amon is to drive one of the Ferraris, and the John Wyre Ford GT40s are there for Ickx and Oliver and Halewood and Hobbs. I talk to team manager David York.
Obviously, it's at a bigger disadvantage this year than it was last year. I think on lap times it won't be very far off the other cars. The thing that's against it is its weight, and braking and accelerating puts an added strain on those two components, the brakes and the transmission. This is what is against the car.
One of the British private entries is Peter Sadler's GT40, which he shares with Paul Vesti. Discussion follows discussion on the Porsche affair. Their cars are allowed to practice, but will they race? That's the big question. The five fastest in practice are all Porsches. Number 12, Vic Elford's 917, is second at 3 minutes 25.1 seconds, 147 miles an hour. But Rolf Stommelen, number 14, is 2 seconds quicker. Film star Steve McQueen is preparing a Le Mans epic for 1970, but as a topic of conversation, Porsche has it. I ask Rico Steinemann how important aerofoils are to the 917.
It's very important because the car is basically being designed with it. The general body design is so that the ailerons played a very important part, and it was just impossible to fix it. We tried it in practice, and it was too dangerous. You know, our drivers aren't kamikaze pilots.
How is it, Vic?
Almost undrivable. It wandered all over the road. It's not an easy car to drive. It's quite heavy and, of course, has a lot of power. As it is, we can get wheel spin in almost any gear at any speed if we try hard enough.
A decision is finally reached. Are you racing, Rico?
We raced the 917 as we brought it here with the movable ailerons, and we shall race the 3-liter as a gesture towards the organizers to show our goodwill with the fixed ailerons, as we found in practice that it doesn't affect the handling so much on the 3-liter because it's a slower car.
Chris, as a former winner of Le Mans race in 1966, how do you rate the 24 hours as a race?
Well, as a race, it's a very, very difficult race to win, and you don't necessarily win it by actually racing. You know, to get to the end of 24 hours with these sort of cars is quite something. It's very difficult.
Vic, what would winning Le Mans mean to you?
It would mean the achievement of one of my greatest ambitions. I think that just about sums it up.
Do you like Le Mans as a race?
I've never driven here before, so I'm really not qualified to say, but I believe it's quite interesting.
In the eyes of the public, Le Mans is probably the most important prototype race of the year.
To see the circuit, we travel at just on race speed in Peter Sadler's GT40. Into the right-hander after the pits and up to the Dunlop Bridge. Then it's the S's to Tertre Rouge and the Mulsanne Straight. On race day, the fast cars will be handicapped by slower ones, some as much as 100 miles an hour slower. Listen to Vic Alford.
Yes, 100 miles an hour is a very big differential, and we have to make tremendous allowances for this.